We can't afford to be so reckless, Jacaro. Losing Theron is bad enough. What if we'd lost you too?
Now, everyone, stay calm. Queen Lena of Onderon once faced a similar predicament, and her solution was quite creative.
Shut up, droid!
What's going on? Where's Theron?
He was captured. The Novablade's data listed a Revanite safe house here in town, and when we tried to investigate... Theron is the only one the Revanites saw. They may not know about the rest of us. If so, we need to maintain that advantage.
You made a tough call, but I think it was probably the right one.
I really think you're all much too worried. They took him alive! That's a good sign. They're probably just torturing him a bit. Maybe doing some interrogation, where he could tell them about us. Oh no!
That won't be an issue. Theron has several discreet implants to help him ignore pain and chemical manipulation.
What if Revan or one of his followers used the Force? Couldn't they read his mind?
I've never been able to. Yes, I've tried. I'm sure it's no surprise. Theron's mind is highly ordered, very resolute, probably due to his childhood training by the Jedi. He'll keep our secrets and we will rescue him. But right now, we need to focus and think it all through, just like he would.
You're right. We need to stick to the mission. When we find the Revanites, we'll find Theron.
Precisely. If we're fortunate, he may even learn a bit about their plans. Now, what did you learn from the Mandalorians?
Revan has a hidden fleet here on Rishi. He's preparing for some kind of battle.
A hidden fleet. Pirates altering shipping lanes. That's it. They aren't just affecting the shipping lanes, they're also changing Imperial and Republic patrol paths.
Revan is trying to draw them into a battle.
Here, over Rishi, with his own ships in the mix, both fleets could be devastated.
That must be his goal. Weakening both sides so that he can make his own play.
We have to find some way to interfere.
I know where to find them! After they caught Theron, I intercepted their transmissions. After that, triangulating their base was a simple calculation. I completed it almost 87 seconds ago. They're on a small island not far from here. The native Rishi have a trading village on the same island. I'm sure they'd give us comfortable lodging.
Then let's go.
We need to clean up any trail we might have left here. You go on, we'll meet you shortly.
Oh, I used to love cleaning.
The future, Tal Hota.
Greetings. We watched you fighting on the beach. The other off-worlders were very unkind. We are much friendlier. Have you come to trade? Do you need lodgings? Outsiders are always welcome here.
Thank you for the warm welcome. I'm surprised you're so open to outsiders.
We love outsiders. You all have such interesting things to say. An entirely new off-worlder. We've never encountered your language. Please, speak more.
Oh, there's no need for that, I assure you. I can speak quite well for both of us. Allow me to introduce...
The second head speaks too. I assumed it was decorative. How fascinating.
You mentioned the other off-worlders earlier, the ones who attacked me. What do you know about them?
We don't know much. I'm afraid they usually avoid us. It seems a little rude, but we know that our ways are different. They have some camps on the island. They wear different colors, dark in one, light in the other, but they all work together, like you.
Revenites. Some from the Republic, some from the Empire.
I think you're right. I'm still going over the data Theron decoded from the Nova Blades. Go to those camps and interfere any way you can.
Save the reading for later. It'd be nice to have you along for once.
I'd like to, but I really don't think you'll need my help. My time is better spent here. May the Force serve you well.
All right, you're here.
You got us.
The commander of Havoc Squad. Expert at executing traitors. That's what your mission here is all about, right?
There's no mission, Captain. I'm here on my own.
Then you're even crazier than I thought. We've sworn to overthrow the governments who've kept the galaxy divided for so long. To end this war. How can you possibly justify standing in our way?
You're betraying the Republic, causing thousands of deaths, all on the word of a single madman.
Revan sees through the lies. He knows how to save the galaxy.
From what? War? Revan's been fighting this war for centuries. He's obsessed with it. This guy says he's going to save us all. But he's manipulating and killing an awful lot of people along the way. Will there be anyone left to save when he's done?
I don't know. What do you want from me? Huh? Why are you saying all of this?
I believe you want to do what's right. And if you go back to the Republic, you still can.
You're serious? Just like that, huh? After everything that's happened.
Why not?
This is crazy. All right. I can't speak for everyone, but I'll give the Republic one last shot.
We're with you, Cap.
Thanks. For all this. And good luck.
With all of the security alerts, I was expecting more. Do us all a favor and die quickly, soldier. You've wasted enough of our time as it is.
Your friends in the Republic camp already tried to stop me. Every last one of them is dead now. Do you want that to happen here?
I think we know how to deal with problems a bit better than Milanek and his pitiful followers.
You're back. The Rishi told us about some disturbances in the camps.
I dealt with them both. Theron is being held in another Revanite stronghold nearby. Do we know anything about it?
The Valley facility? We just learned about it ourselves. The Rishi tell us there are quite a few starships hidden in the vicinity.
Revan's fleet?
Precisely. And according to the Nova Blade's data logs, his plan is moving swiftly. Fleets from the Empire and Republic are approaching as we speak. These aren't just small patrol groups. Both navies have gathered their most powerful warships. They're being overseen directly by Darth Maar and Satil Shan.
Both factions must believe this could be a decisive engagement. They don't know the half of it. What do we know about the Revanite facility?
It seems to be their primary operating center on Rishi. Heavy security with only one clear path of approach. You'll have to attack straight on if we're to have any hope of rescuing Theron and stopping this fleet battle.
Then that's what I'll do.
We'll assist you any way that we can. Good luck. communications terminal and activate it. I'll attempt to slice in remotely. Toys make all of this slicing much simpler than I'd imagined.
Can you find any hard data on his location?
Let's see. Here we are. Recorded interrogation sessions. Coordinates are included. I'll forward them along.
What about Revan?
No information either way. I'd advise caution.
You've interfered enough. Intact.
Another pointless attack.
Where's Theron?
He and I have had some interesting conversations. My own flesh and blood, completely blind to the sacrifices I've made. I've struggled for centuries to preserve the galaxy, to protect future generations from the most destructive evil that's ever existed. How can none of you see this?
You aren't the one paying the price for the battle you're fighting. What could possibly justify the destruction you're causing?
I suppose I shouldn't expect a mere soldier to understand the bigger picture.
You're here. Come on, we have to go. Now.
Theron?
Escaped all on your own. I hoped I would have more time to make you see.
He's got a signal jammer that's blocking all starship communications in the Risi system. The fleets will come out of hyperspace practically on top of each other. No coordination, saboteurs in every crew. It'll be a massacre.
And at last, the board will be cleared of distractions.
Self-destruct sequence. Come on, we've gotta go.
Look out!
Is everyone all right?
Lana, you shut down the self-destruct?
I'm beginning to get the hang of this slicing business.
I've created a monster.
You should hurry back. The Republic and Imperial fleets will be arriving very soon.
Understood. Moving out.
I'll meet you there. Need to grab a few things on the way out. Attacking from the air is pointless. The anti-air defenses are much too thick.
I'm afraid of them, doesn't that count? What are our other options?
I think a surface attack is our only real shot at taking the jammer down.
Leave that to me.
Perfect. We'll arrange transportation for you.
You've got to move fast. The fleets are going to be dropping out of hyperspace any second now. The longer we take... the more we lose.
You don't sound good, Theron. Shouldn't you be in a Colto tank instead of planning missions?
Probably, but there's no time. I need to finish slicing the last of these Nova Blade files. They have data on every ship with Revanite infiltrators aboard. As soon as the jamming clears, we'll have to broadcast everything we've got to convince the fleets to cease fire and lock up the Revanites and their crews. One last thing, since Lana stepped out. Watch your back. I'm starting to think my little visit to the Revanites might have been her idea.
You think she's working for the Revanites?
No, but I don't think she's putting all her cards on the table either. Just stay alert, all right?
This isn't the time to start dividing ourselves with suspicion. We have to stay united.
Maybe you're right. I don't know. We can sort it all out after that jammer's down. Good luck.
I don't know if you can read me, but I've arrived.
We read you.
Jammer's in sight.
I'll do what I can to guide you through, but that signal jammer might cause some hiccups.
You are fit for duty. Return to your post.
Signs on nil, sir.
Thank you.
Engaging hostile.
Okay, you're in. There's a force field between you and that jammer. You'll have to gather a set of security codes to pass through. Signal's going to start breaking up soon. Talk to you when you get that jammer shut down.
We cannot fail!
Incoming.
The galaxy needs us!
Hostile engagement initiated. Shouldn't take long. Priming electromatrix. Affirmative. Taking them out. Putting up much of a fight. Not putting up much of a fight. Friendly's acknowledged. Lost it! Taking damage!
Republic Fleet, come in. Do you read me?
Flagship Dauntless here, patching you through to the command deck.
This is Satil Shan. Do we have you to thank for shutting down that jammer?
That, and a whole lot more.
There are traitors hiding on every ship in your fleet. The Imperial ships, too. They're manipulating the battle from both sides.
I'm transmitting the traitors' names now. They're part of a cult. The Order of Revan.
Revan? But he was killed.
Apparently it didn't take.
All ships cease fire. Open a channel to the Imperial Commander.
I've been listening. As ruses go, this is quite creative.
It's the truth. Round up the people from Theron's list and see for yourself.
And if you're correct, what do you propose?
A meeting. Face-to-face on neutral ground.
There's a town on the surface, Raiders Cove. We'll send coordinates for the meeting spot.
Very well.
I hope you know what you're doing.
Kidding.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he pretty much knows already.
Would anyone like some refreshments? We have several fine beverages available.
No, thank you. I'm fine.
All right. Off to a good start.
Do we have casualty reports from the fleet battle?
It was bad, but it could have been much worse.
The Revanite ships have all been scattered, captured, or destroyed. Their accomplices aboard our vessels are in chains. You found a threat and given us the means to root it out. Separately, what do we have to discuss?
Revan is still alive, my lord, and his plans don't stop here.
The Emperor's not dead. Revan thinks he can fix that, but he's wrong. Isn't he?
No one person, not even Revan, can truly destroy the Emperor.
I don't care how much force nonsense is involved, anybody can be killed.
The Emperor can be destroyed, but not by Revan. The Emperor's current state is nebulous, incorporeal. To strike at him, Revan will first have to return him to a physical form.
Which is exactly what the Emperor wants.
He will destroy Revan, then move on to the rest of us. In time, he will consume all life in the galaxy.
How do we prevent it? How do we stop Revan?
The Emperor's hideaway is a secret, even to the Dark Council.
The fourth moon of Yavin. That's where we'll find Revan. He wanted me to join him there. Never said I couldn't bring a few friends.
According to our data, he still has extensive forces at his disposal. We would stand a better chance of overcoming them together.
No matter what evidence I present, I doubt the Supreme Chancellor will agree to any kind of alliance or truce.
Neither will the Dark Council, but my ships and the soldiers aboard them are loyal to me.
I can convince my troops to maintain a truce. They've seen Revan's threat firsthand.
Then we meet on Yavin 4.
Agreed.
Theron.
We can talk on the way to Yavin. I have some business to finish here.
Thank you for your help. All of you. This can't have been easy.
The conspiracy is finally exposed. We've been hiding our actions from our allies for so long, it's a relief to have everything in the open.
So we can talk about how you threw me to the wolves now?
I made a calculated strategic decision, and it worked, as we can all see now.
And if you had talked to me about it, I would have volunteered, but you didn't even give me a choice.
We couldn't risk the Revanites knowing that your capture was a ploy. You had to be in the dark for the plan to work.
If the Revanites knew your capture was staged, they would have killed you and we wouldn't have learned Revan's plan. Hiding the truth was probably the best option.
We've got exactly one professional spy in this group. I could have handled it.
I think it's time we moved on. Yavin is a long way from here.
Agreed. Let's get moving.
Lana, stay a moment. We should talk.
Of course.
Enjoy your trip to Yavin!
This is quite a mess I've made, isn't it? The wicked Sith can't be trusted. Just the sentiment we need right now.
I wouldn't be spending so much time around you if I couldn't stand a little bit of intrigue.
Makes sense. The moments we've shared, the connection between us, it's very important to me. I would never want to lose your trust. My strength flows from the passions I embrace, my service to the Empire, and you.
I guess I can't be surprised you'd put the Empire first.
And there we are again. This truce won't last forever. Even if we succeed, the war won't end. There's no future for us.
I'm not ready to give up. Are you?
Not yet. But time is not our ally. We should hurry along.
My master wishes to report that the surrounding terrain is quite rugged. The Revanites are based in an ancient temple nearby. We found no usable supplies or shelter.
The other scouts gave similar reports. There has been some contact with Revanite patrols, but no heavy resistance as yet.
We've got a base camp, elevation, decent perimeter. Bring me up to speed on the rest.
We need better eyes on the region around us. Scouts can only patrol so far and brush this dense.
It is more than that. I sense their fear, their distrust. This world is mired in ancient hatreds. and we have brought more than our share already.
Was there a suggestion somewhere in all that?
The troops are too distracted by each other to keep a proper lookout. They're expecting to be stabbed in the back.
Then we'll set an extended perimeter past the outer guards and make it impartial. Sensor equipment doesn't pick sides.
I can take care of that.
Once our position is secure, we can focus on Revan.
Do we know any more about how Revan is intending to bring the Emperor back?
Everything about the Emperor is a mystery, even to the Dark Council. Speed is our only ally now.
We'll keep in touch while you're getting those sensors up.
Good luck.
Greetings. You are cleared for the following travel routes.
You didn't take it.
When I saw him through my...
finished landing the sensors.
Good work. Before you come back to base, I think an extra modification is in order. With a few tweaks, we can set the sensors to forward us extra data on Imperial activities. They won't even know it's happening.
You want to spy on the Empire's forces?
I think recent events have taught us to keep an eye over our shoulder. We won't be doing anything to damage their capabilities, just staying informed on them.
You don't have to convince me. Just walk me through the modifications.
All right, start with the internal communications processor. That should do it. I'll scrub our chat from the comm lab. You should get back to base. Theron out.
Welcome.
You sense it, too. Not the ancient Sith, or the Emperor. Not Revan. Another presence. Different from the rest.
Yes. It is more like you.
Are you saying there's another Jedi somewhere near us?
No Jedi could survive here alone. It is a vestige, at most.
You sell us a bit short, Mar. But in answer to your question, no. Presence isn't exactly that of a Jedi, either. It's still very difficult to pinpoint.
Sensors are picking up something a bit more solid. Large structures, mixture of ancient and modern materials. Looks like they've been ransacked. Lots of debris.
Check for broadcasts in signal range 47.2.
What am I seeing here? It's encoded.
The facts behind a rumor. That signal range is used only by the Imperial Guard. The structure we've found must be their training facility.
I fought the Imperial Guard on Corellia. They were dangerous opponents.
Among the most dangerous in the galaxy.
If the Guard has a facility here, they may have information on the Emperor's hiding place. That would lead us straight to Revan.
Agreed. As this concerns only Imperial interests, I will assemble a team of my own to investigate. Beniko, with me.
We can't sit back and watch. There's no telling what they might pull out of that facility. We can't just take their word for it.
Hurry. While Mar is gathering his team, make your way out of the camp and search the Imperial Guard base as quickly as possible.
We'll stall the EMs as much as we can. Let's just hope this doesn't turn ugly.
I've seen more than one covert op that backfired when the truth came out. Is this worth the risk?
We don't have any other options. Trust is hard enough when we're on even footing. If they get an edge on us, forget it.
Please hurry. And may the Force be with you.
Greetings. You are cleared for the following travel routes.
bet you anything it's less tense out there than it is in here. Well, the same. Watch yourself.
Invaders! Interlopers! This world is off limits! He told us from the start, only the devoted, only the purest, his orders, his command!
Great. Someone to question and he's lost his mind.
No, no, I see clearly. His sight can never be lost.
You were attacked by the followers of a man named Revan. Do you know where he's gone?
To the temple. And from there, the final steps are walked. We have failed, but so will he. Plans within plans, always. This too has been foreseen. All possibilities are witnessed and adjusted for.
What are you talking about?
The end is inevitable. All will be devoured to fuel his transcendence. All nations, all worlds, all species. You, me, Revan! None will survive! Let the end begin! In service of his glory! In service of his glory! In service of his glory! My death serves his will, as all do. We are the fuel. Our sacrifice ignites his blazing glory!
I see you've made a new friend.
This man is the only survivor of Revan's attack. We need to take him back to the camp for questioning.
Then we will. Return to the camp. We have much to discuss.
Closer.
This was an imperial matter. Your soldiers' involvement was unwelcome.
We're supposed to be working together. If the situations were reversed, wouldn't you have done the same thing?
You don't trust us.
We were concerned and we acted. We should have left this to you. Apologies.
You don't speak for them.
Kill each other now? Wait until later. It's all the same. It all fuels the flame.
Enough. I will wrench the information we need from this man. The rest can be settled later.
Interrogate him however you see fit.
I encourage you to observe. I have no need for secrets.
Allowing this torture makes us no better than Revan.
We can be better than Revan after he's dealt with.
I need to meditate on the path ahead. There must be a way forward without such sacrifices.
And at least a few of us had better check up on Mar and Lana.
Darth Mar's techniques are quite effective. I don't believe we'll have much longer to wait. I want you to know I advised against Mar's plan with the guard facility. We've come so far together. I'd hate to see that progress ruined by territoriality.
This truce is only as strong as our trust in each other.
Then with our guidance, I think it can only become stronger as we proceed.
I thought the interrogation we faced on Manon was severe. Darth Mar made that little session seem like a picnic.
Let's find out what we're up against.
A device for mass ritual sacrifice? That's seriously what he called it?
Capable of killing every living thing on this moon as fuel for the Emperor's resurrection.
And housed within the very temple the Revanites are using as their base of operations.
So we'll have to breach the temple and shut the weapon down before Revan can activate it.
Getting inside at all will be challenging enough.
The temple entrance has a locking system that can be overridden from the outside, provided we find the right mechanisms.
On it.
I certainly never thought we'd be killed by an ancient Sith murder machine.
We're fortunate to have run into each other.
Think I found the locks Ivan mentioned. You better get out there and take a look. We'll feed you info as we find it.
Good luck.
Greetings. You are cleared for the following travel routes. Please use all products only as intended.
Watch out for those, Miss Sassy. They're no joke.
Yes. Your arrival has been foreseen. You must press on.
Get massive support soon. We're all dead, and I didn't sign up to get eaten.
You're close. I feel it. Hurry. Good. You have opened the way.
Revan, how is this possible?
Through the Force, anything is possible. When the Emperor's followers struck me down, I learned to release my attachments.
Then who's wearing your mask and leading your followers?
I do not know. But I recognize much of myself in him. The darkness I left behind. He must be stopped. His fury will only strengthen the Emperor, not destroy him.
I'm sorry I wasn't there to fight with you. We might have been able to avoid all of this.
It's good that you didn't. I told myself that I was not altered by my centuries in the Emperor's grasp. But my actions were those of a madman, consumed by rage. I am glad to have left such evil behind. You must do what I could not.
Thank you.
You've done it. The way is opening.
I just spoke to Revan.
You what? He was there?
It was his spirit. He couldn't tell me who was wearing his mask, but he did confirm that trying to kill the Emperor wouldn't work.
The man who tortured me was an imposter? How could he know so much?
We can sort that out when we face him. For now, we need to focus on the weapon he has primed inside the temple.
You're right. We're only going to get one shot at this. Once our forces enter the temple, it's only a matter of time until our friend pulls the trigger.
A joint strike, committing all of our forces and the Empire's, has a good chance of pushing through the temple and disabling the weapon before it can fire.
An operation like that needs perfect coordination and trust. It might take some doing to get our troops working together at that level.
What about a small unit operation?
A small team might be able to infiltrate the temple and reach the device before it can be activated, but they'll be facing some steep odds.
You've led the mission this far. Our victory is within reach. We'll let you decide how best to achieve it. Revan's spirit.
Medical attention. Be well. Please use all products only as intended.
Ready?
All teams report ready. You've done very well. All of the soldiers here look up to you. Imperial and Republic both.
Let's proceed.
All units, move out. All units report success. The weapon has been shut down and all Revanites neutralized. Only one more left to deal with.
Ivan told us where Revan might go. The Emperor's final sanctuary.
We've got speeders prepped. You won't be facing him alone.
I'll take all the backup I can get. Let's move.
Your entire army's barely managed to drive me back. You think you'll be able to face me without them?
No soldier fights alone.
Shay Vizsla?
Wouldn't miss a fight this good.
Bring as many fools as you like. You won't stop what must be done.
You don't know what you're doing. The Emperor is too powerful.
No, not any longer. I have set my will against this creature for centuries. Only I can destroy him.
But you aren't Revan.
Who else could do what I've done? Who else would have the strength to come this far? I am Revan, and I will complete the work I started so long ago.
Take a step back. Look at what you're doing. You're only going to make the Emperor stronger. This is what he wants, don't you see that?
You understand nothing. I know his mind better than anyone living. I know what must be done.
Can't you see what you've become? Your hatred and regrets are consuming you.
My own flesh and blood standing against me. The depths of his corrupting influence are endless. I will waste no more time. This must end now! This will be the end of you! You cannot deny me!
I will see you break!
I must have my revenge!
So much power!
I have come too far!
He is strong with the Force.
I must have my revenge.
Servant.
You are sealing the galaxy's fate.
I won't let you win, Revan.
I have come too far.
Get him, Jacaro!
Fall!
He is strong with the Force.
You are sealing the galaxy's fate.
Let's go, people!
You cannot deny me!
I will see you break.
I have come too far. It can't be.
What's happening?
Impossible. The ritual hasn't even begun.
The deaths you've caused, the war you've fueled, it is all mine. This galaxy is mine. It's time I claimed it once more.
Sound off. Any injuries?
We're fine.
That was him.
The Emperor.
How is that possible? We stopped Revan.
He did not assume a physical form or possess a body, and he left as soon as he appeared. None of it makes sense.
Still packs a punch.
The General is entirely misinformed, Your Eminence. A few coats of paint, and I'll be ready for the Lunar Gala.
Looks like we weren't the only survivors.
He might be able to tell us more about what's happened.
I've failed.
As have I. So many centuries. The Emperor and his dread masters trying to wrench me apart, to unleash my anger and hatred. I detached myself from the pain, focused on the Force.
You hid behind Jedi platitudes. You weren't strong enough to survive the torture or the battle in the Foundry. I faced them. I survived them.
You've carried on, dragging the remains of a body that should have long since faded to dust. Hatred fueled cunning, but burned out all wisdom. Without me, you could not see.
Strength is useless without some wisdom to guide it.
We need to repair what the Emperor has done. I am whole again. But there is much to do. The Emperor has returned. Steel yourselves against what will come.
Let's get back to base camp. He was right. We have a lot to do.
Your actions are confusing, to say the least. I don't appreciate being left in the dark.
Does the Supreme Commander share these concerns, Chancellor?
He does not, but that is hardly...
The two of us have been fighting this war for quite some time now. We know what we're doing, and we appreciate your trust in us.
Just as I'll appreciate being informed when your fleet is back in position, so rush out.
I guess ignoring the boss runs in the family.
Ignoring Suresh is always a good idea.
Never knew you were so political.
Our forces are preparing to launch.
I should make sure ours are ready to do the same.
It's strange. The next time we meet, our circumstances will be... quite different.
Well, don't take it personally, but I'm hoping that you'll never see me again.
And I'll hope that I do.
I'm gonna see if Satil needs any help. Catch me later.
Well, our time has come, even sooner than I'd feared. Revan is gone. We've accomplished what we set out to do. But now we have an entirely new problem, and no truce to face it.
We've shown that it's possible to ignore our differences. Maybe there's hope for a real treaty.
Despite our work here, trust is still in short supply. We can thank the Revanites for that. What's next for the Republic's most decorated soldier? Surely even Havoc Squad gets vacations every now and then.
Maybe I'll just disappear for a bit. Surely the Republic can get by without me for a little while?
I'd say you've earned it. Though I doubt your superiors would be interested in my opinion. I'm not at all sure what my future holds. But the future doesn't have to start for a while yet. For now, I'd like to make the most of the present.
There's nothing I'd like more.
I'm going to miss you.
Give me a call if you ever want to change sides.
You'll be the first to know.
The Imperials are leaving a small force of volunteers behind to watch for any further activity from the Revanites or the Emperor. We'll be doing the same.
As it happens, Jakaro and I have received several lucrative business offers. Various acquaintances made on Rishi, nothing to concern yourselves with. That being said, we have sincerely enjoyed our time with you, and would gladly provide our services again at any time.
Why go work with someone else? I'd be happy to have you stick around and join my crew.
A tempting offer!
There's more for us to discuss.
Thanks to your old boss, Spec Force Division is going through some changes. We can't afford to lose Havoc Squad in that mire of bureaucracy.
A special joint task force is being assembled between the Jedi, the SIS, and the military. Destroying the Sith Emperor is the group's sole purpose.
On the recommendation of Supreme Commander Malcolm, you have been appointed to serve as the task force's primary military advisor. Congratulations.
I can't think of a more important mission to be a part of. I'm honored.
We're lucky to have you.
We're attempting to calculate where the Emperor might have gone, but we don't know enough about his capabilities to determine anything for sure.
While we get the task force up and running, we're going to need you out there acting on your own. Follow every lead you can find.
And remember, the threat of the Empire remains. They will not hesitate to use this situation to gain an advantage over us. Until the Emperor is destroyed for good, the entire galaxy is in danger. We must be ready.